Okay, so here we are in our editor again, and this is the basic HTML file we were editing before and that we were opening in our browser. We're going to go back to this a little bit so we can learn some new form elements. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is remove the action parameter from the form element so that we can submit the form to itself, and we'll see the queue parameter in the URL again. And this makes it easy to demonstrate what's going on without having to go back to our app server and all of that stuff. Okay, so I remove that. Let's go to our browser, and let's give this form a test. All right, so I reload the page. I type in some junk here, which it auto-completes for me. I click submit, and we see some junk in the URL. Q equals some junk. Okay, let's go back to our editor. Okay, so here we are in our editor. One thing I've been leaving off is the type parameter on this first input. So let's go ahead and add that. Type equals text. Type equals text is the default type of an input parameter. I didn't include it originally because I didn't want to spend a whole lot of time talking about that at the time. But in reality, we want to be a little bit more specific with our types, especially now that we're going to learn some new types. So if I change that to type text, the behavior won't change in the browser. And the first thing we're going to do is learn a new type. So instead of being text, we're going to change this to password. The password type is useful for entering passwords in the text box. OK, so here we are in our browser. Now when we type some text into the box here, it appears as dots instead of the actual text. So for the next quiz, what I'd like you to do is tell me what happens when I click the submit button. You can try this out on your own at home.